from AstraZeneca to J&J COVID-19 vaccine. Why the big switch for South Africa? South Africa is in a very odd combat position against COVID-19. While the government has secured numerous doses of the AstraZeneca-Oxford vaccine, it may switch to the Johnson & Johnson's Janssen vaccine in the meantime. The main reason is the dominant South Africa variant of the coronavirus. Preliminary scientific data showed that the Oxford vaccine is less effective against the variant. That is enough to warrant the decision of South Africa to switch COVID-19 vaccines. One consideration is to swap them with the Janssen vaccine, despite the latter having no conditional approval from the US FDA at this time. According to Associated Press, the AstraZeneca-Oxford vaccine is preferred by many for its cheaper price and convenient storage requirements, particularly over the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine. But those two factors may not matter if the drug won't work against the more contagious variant. One clinical study showed that the Janssen vaccine was 57% effective against moderate to severe COVID-19 caused by the variant. After 28 days, the effectiveness was found 85% against severe disease. In the press release by AstraZeneca, investigators published a preprint of interim results in The Lancet. The preprint showed that the vaccine is safe and effective in preventing COVID-19 without severe cases and hospitalizations over 22 days after the first dose. The vaccine efficacy rate was 76% after the initial dose and would be maintained by the second dose. When the second dose was given at least 12 weeks after the first shot, the efficacy would go up to 82%. Those are promising scores against the original strain. Additionally, their analysis revealed that the vaccine could lower asymptomatic transmission based on weekly swabs from the UK trial participants. The positive PCR test readings declined by 67% with one dose and 50% with two doses. This supports that COVID-19 vaccines may help reduce the transmissibility of SARS-CoV-2. The University of Oxford, meanwhile, analyzed a two-dose regimen of the vaccine against mild and moderate COVID-19 cases involving the B.1.351 South Africa variant. Along with the University Witwatersrand and others in South Africa, investigators discovered that the effectiveness of neutralizing antibodies induced by the vaccine is significantly reduced against the new variant compared to the original strain. Although the vaccine could still provide some level of protection, no government would deploy less effective vaccines against variants dominating its territory. That might just lead to bigger problems in the long run. But if vaccine makers could tweak their products, governments would reconsider the improvements.